That's one of the worst rivers I could see. He got there. He might not go there if I race, so I guess that's on me, but he three bets me from big blind, so when someone three bets from big blind, I'm always I always respect that, actually, that race, so we'll see. King 3 suited. Nah, I'm not going to defend. I would defend if Kevlord here would be a what's called Yura. He actually left the table, so yeah. He's really tight, so I might start, like I said, I might start color coding players here. We'll see. I just don't want I guess I have to bluff here again, and he's probably calling me. Oh, he has a pair, so okay, he's really passive with pairs, so I have to make a mental note about that. So like I said, but about color text, I don't want to, like, I don't want to color like this player here, farm player. I just seem wrong here at 5, 10, 10 cents table. I need to say hello to volleyballs here. Yeah, I was I kind of knew he was from Latvia. Seems like a Latvian nickname. He said hi, right? Can't say it now. Of course, full house is betting. Let me just say. Sure, raising 6-8 here, that seems fine. Hey, volleyballs, good luck. I'm just checking if I wrote his nickname correctly. I mean, he calls again, but I don't think he's doing that with pair of tens. That would just be a bit too much. Bull rent horribly again, so I'm just going to check call here. Let's see how we're doing. I guess we are doing about the samey. Oh, we are $3.8 in profit for now. Hey, Oscar Rabbit, welcome to the chat. Also, PLO, are you familiar with? Well, I know what PLO is. I tried to learn it. I was playing it for like 2 months or something like that. I'm obviously still a fish in PLO, but yeah, I am familiar with it, I hope so. If I weren't playing Fixed Limit Hold'em, I would definitely play PLO. I wouldn't play No Limit, I've said this before. No Limit seems... I don't want to say boring, but... Fixed Limit, I mean, it might not seem like that, but Fixed Limit is way more dynamic than No Limit, I think. Sure, you don't have a all-in button, but all-in button is not everything, really. You play so many pots here, you play so many hands in Fixed Limit Hold'em, and it's fun. And I guess it's the same with PLO. You also play lots of hands there. Wow, he actually raised me for the first time today. I am really, really worried now. Yeah, I'm falling. I'm so worried I'm actually falling. I'm just hoping that my tens are good here. I mean, they might not be. He might have a jacks here. I wouldn't be surprised if he shows me jacks. But no, he folds. He might even fold the better hand than mine. Can't really believe that, but who knows. Just a second, guys. Mr. Maximus Mix. Yeah, it's not Mr. Maximus. It's Maximus raised here. I mean, does he really have a queen here? I guess he does. Okay, he has a quads here. I am way fine with losing against squads. That's not really a problem. So, nice hand, sir. Let's say nice hand. Yeah, Jack Knight here. I'm going in the pot because there's so many players already in. Flopping pretty good. Yeah, talking about PLO. Like I said, if I wouldn't play Figures Limited, I would definitely play PLO. Such a fun game, really. I am check raising here. Yes, I am check raising here, of course. What the hell? Some weird song playing. Let me just do it like this. Yeah. It's a pretty crappy turn. If I were kind of representing also king here besides my flash draw, that ace makes everything worse basically. But I'm now check raising. But I guess they got a read on me that I actually hit a flush here. Yeah, too bad. I almost never. I'm almost, well, they actually got here two tens. He got king nine. Well, I almost never do something like that on when there are good players in. But I was kind of expecting people to just bet here. We are playing for like an hour now, and we see that if you check here, people are betting. I mean, we were betting with nothing, so. That's why, I mean, I was just hoping that they would basically continue with either a pair of kings or I thought someone would hit a pair of dead ace on a turn, but nope, unfortunately not. Should have just dunk bet out in hindsight now, right? King 7, sure. I mean, I'm on two tables here. Motalach, the second, is really tight table. And Bredicina here is like just the opposite, really. These two tables can't be more different, really. It's funny. And this one is a mixed one. Sure, King 4 offsuit is fine to open here. In small blind versus big blind battle, I always like these battles. Flopping top pair is also nice. Yeah, folding. I mean, he really has a jack. I'm check raising here. If he has a jack, he's going to raise. If he's bluffing, I don't really mind that. if he has a straight, he's also betting. So okay, he folds. So not sure what he had there. I don't think he would fold the jack there. I mean, he might have a straight. I don't know. He wouldn't fold the straight. No idea what he had. Too bad he didn't call. I'm curious. I'm curious what he had there. So, how are we doing? Let's see. Ooh, $5 in. Wow, that's like a quarter of our bankroll, man. That's pretty good. We are progressing pretty fast, actually. We are also running pretty good, so I have to say that. So, we are winning 25 big bets per 100 hands, so that's, that's unsustainable, really. You missed the PLO answer. Oh, come on, really? I can say it again. It's no problem. But I'll be a bit faster this time. I was saying that I am familiar with PLO. I played for like 2 months or so. I tried to learn it, but I'm still a fish at it, really. But I am familiar with it. If I wouldn't be playing Fixed Limit Hold'em, I would definitely play PLO. That's what I basically said. That's too long didn't read coded for you. Volleyball is he was he asking me anything? Nope. Let's see if he has a question or something, or why is he doing Luca question. Maximus raised here, so I believe him. I believe he has a king here, so I'm just check calling and hoping to spike either an ace or a flush. Let's see. Nope. So I guess we just fold. Flopping again good here against HPC. Flopping good but running bad in later streets. But I guess it was good enough. Okay. He called me with ace high, I guess. Yep. He had an ace high. Okay, you can see that. I have to get used to it that you can see my heart. Man, I have to have this open all the time. Yeah, I'll have open this open this window open all the time, so it's a replay window. I actually never use this replay window. I always use the text one here, like this one. So Naita said that I have to use this one because it's pretty and it has pictures and whatnot. So yeah, and I agree. King, it wasn't the best. Queen is even the worst. So I'm just check calling. Hope he bets with Ace Jack or something like that. He actually has top pair King. That's fine. He made a pretty weird call on the flop, but I guess that's what people do at these limits. I mean, if you want to win I mean, in any game or in any limits, you need to expect people to play bad, really. So if you see someone calling here and getting there on a turn or whatever, you shouldn't be mad or anything like that. You have to be grateful. I mean, really, because you make money. The only way you make money is from people's mistakes. So yeah, even if they if I English, even if they get there from time to time. So yeah. Let me just make a sip of water here, real quick, guys. Nope. I defend a lot from someone who opens from the bottom, but not this time. Ooh, someone new to the chat, and let's butcher his nickname. Let's butcher your nickname. Istachiquatl? That sounds like a perfect pronunciation to me. Welcome to the chat. Thanks for joining the live stream. Yeah, let's bluff. Let's just bluff here. Kill Lord, let's bluff Kill Lord and he falls. My ace was believable here, so why not, right? Jax. Big Baller 5500. Hello to you too. Welcome to the chat. Who's streaming today? Let's see real quick. Oh, Felix is already streaming. Subscriber sweat. Ted on play. Poker, funny guy, okay. Yeah. I decided to live stream a bit earlier today, It's like 3 o'clock here in Central Europe time zone. Guess that might be a bit too early, but I don't know. We'll see. I'm also going to do the evening live streams or something like that. So yeah. But for now, I think this time of the day, actually, seems the best for me. At least for live streams. I usually play in the evening, so I mean my I usually play in the evening, so because there are not enough tables, I guess. I mean, in this time of day, so yeah, it's better to play in the evening, of course. My regular limits, my regular stuff, and just do the live streams in the noon or something like that. Delay there. That's a 2 minute delay, big baller. I don't have a bot or anything like that set up yet. So, oh, whoa. I have a top pair. I have a nine here. Wow. I just thought. Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm talking too much, I guess. Of course, I need to bet now my trips. Oh, that was bad. Now it seems like I was slow playing or whatever. I just completely misread my hand here. I thought it was like 10-6-9, 10-6-8, and I have a I don't know. Ugh. Really, you missed it again? Oh, come on. I'm not doing this the third time. I'm uploading this stuff, my live stream here on YouTube's later, so you can watch it there. Thanks for the follow, Istachihuatl. I guess that was great to say, so I'm glad. I usually butcher people's name. I mean, sometimes I read like German names pretty well, I think. Maybe some others like Scandinavians. I think, I mean, that's at least that's what I think. I'm probably still bad, but I guess I might be better than average, but yeah. But others are yeah, I'm just better at other names. He called and raised me there. I have a top pair. I'm never folding in blind versus blind battle. He also bets an ace, so he either has a really monster hand or he has a bluff here. Really, that's okay. He actually called and raised with pair of queens. That was wow. That was a bit of unlucky for me. He had ace queen here. Medicopter! Oh, thank you for the follow. Didn't know this. Didn't know this before. Flopping top pair. After this hand, if we win after this hand, I'm going to refresh my graph at the bottom. but only if we win. If we not, I'm not going to refresh it. Yeah, that's how we roll. How was the two? You're probably asking about 2 cents, 4 cents level. I never played that level. I actually started with $20 and I started with 5, 10, 10 cents. So this is my first day of bankroll management. This is my first stake. So yeah, didn't play 2 cents, 4 cents. I guess it's a bit too low. I mean, for live streaming here. I am check. I'm raising here, of course. The best top pair ace. Should I be worried now? I don't think so. I think I can put him all in. I don't. I just. Don't, I hope that he doesn't have an ace queen there, and he. And he doesn't. That's fine. You're here this time. Well, I'm glad. He showed me King 10. Oh, he was asking me something before, right? Like Luca, question mark, but he didn't answer. He didn't say anything beside that. Yeah, I usually race when someone limps on small blind, if I want to be blind, of course, so I am doing the same here. Even though he's really showdown bound, as you can, I can see here, you can't see, guys, because you can't see my HUD. But he gets 64% of when to showdown, so that's actually good for me in this point, because I have a pair, but it's bad in general with 5-7 offsuit, I guess. I'm raising with all, basically my whole range, almost my whole range, not my whole range, just because I expect people to fold a lot on the flop, so yeah, that's it. I'm actually surprised that people are not chatting at the tables. When I join these small stakes, I mean micro stakes, people are usually chatty, try to chat with me and stuff like that, but not today. I guess it's too early. It's 3 p.m. It's too early. It's way too early for a poker player. Oh, I said we're going to refresh our hand, our hold'em manager here. So let's do it. Let's see. We are $5.7 in profit. Nice. Doing great now. Can't call here with sevens on ace queen flop. Even my flush draw here isn't good, so just folding is fine. I know. Hashtag I hate folding. Hashtag never fold a pair, but. Oh, and there's a seven. Oh, come on. No, you shouldn't be result oriented, so. It was the correct fold, so. It's all fine. Efficient is going, so let's GG him too. Okay, I think I need to change this table. I don't want to play again only with four players, and if this would be my regular limits, I would definitely change this table, because it's not it's not good enough. Johnny Tricks is saying no because efficient is leading, or why? Yeah, folding 9-10. Am I going to defend against Johnny Tricks if everyone falls to me? I think I have to. Yeah, I am. Okay, Xmas is calling me here. Is donk betting? Oh, it's not donk bet. I limped. Why the hell did I limp? Oh, come on, did you really limp here? I mean, I did, but why? Oh, come on. I'm playing too many tables, guys. I just limped with 5-6 suited. I did that shenanigans here with my pair of eights, so yeah. Okay, poor Rand. Horribly! I can't call it. Or maybe I can. He actually posted a blind, so. Okay, he has a nice. Yeah, thumbs up. Nice hand, let's do a nice hand. Yeah, like I said before, I never trust guys who pay the blind and then play his hand. I always think someone, that they have like 7 deuce of suit. Really? Did he bet on the flop, or how did it go exactly? How do I go faster? Yeah, okay, he bet. Did I check raised? No. Why didn't I check raised? I don't know. It's fine, I guess. I guess this table is. If I see another table, I'm going to. It's almost the same. Yeah, let's take this table. I don't know. Let's do it. GG. Good luck. And let's leave the table. Have to mix it up a bit. How am I table selecting? Well, I hope you are staying here for the next 2 minutes, because I have 2 minute delay, and that means that my answer will come 2 minutes later to you. Or should I maybe wait 2 minutes and then answer you? I don't know. How am I table selecting? Well, today I'm not table selecting at all, really. I mean, okay, I did leave this table just because it seemed a bit bad. I mean, bad in a sense that there were no like loose passive players, really. Just like tight aggressive ones. So that's why I left the table. But besides that, I'm not doing any table selection. I'm just joining the empty tables. I mean, I'm joining the tables that has empty seats, and that's it. But when I am doing when I'm playing my regular stakes, right, from up to 15-30 bucks, I am using Table Scan Turbo. It's a software that scans the tables, and I can see all the players that are at the tables at the moment, and I join the one that are good, basically. That's it. You're wondering about the limp too, yeah. I know, two tables seems like the perfect combination. Two tables, commenting about hands and doing the chat. That's the perfect. It's perfect, but I mean, at least from my point, I'm not sure about not sure about you guys, but from my point, that's the best. Okay, we flopped a magical hand here. I'm going to raise now. Like, I'm raising a king now, right? So I have a king here. Cannibal probably won't believe me. Hope he has an ace. Let's cap. So I guess ace king, ace four, and ace deuce beats me right now. Or ace ace, of course, or king king. I certainly not have the nut here, but I'm pretty sure I have the best hand. So let's see what he had. He had ace king, ace queen. Yep, I was lucky here. I mean, lucky. I was lucky that he didn't hit that queen, or that he didn't have a ace king here. Yeah, let's just fold. I have the nuts here on. I mean, the nut flush here. So of course I'm betting out. I guess we can refresh now that we are doing so good. So $6 in profit. Nice. We almost, that's almost one third of our bankroll. So I mean, raising your bankroll by one third in 1 day, that's pretty good. I mean, sure, it's 5, 10, 10 cents, but if I would run the same in like 50 cents $1 table, that would mean $60. Ace high might be good here. Well, probably not that now that volleyballs bets. Leaving soon, playing 20 side progressive, knocking, good game. Well, good luck to him. Good luck at turning then, sir. Johnny Tricks. How is the limit action nowadays? Well, I think the whole. Okay, now you're just trolling with you, Wasklywabbit. Okay, I'm fine with that. Like, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on you. Fool me three times, shame on you. Fool me four times, shame on me. Right? I think that's how that saying goes. Okay, you were just kidding. Okay. But yeah. The joke's on me, obviously, here. How is limit action? I mean, fixed limit hold'em is obviously not the most popular format out there, obviously. I mean, that's duh. I mean, there's obviously no limit PLO, and I guess then there's fixed limit, so it's the third one. It's the third most popular game. At least I hope so. I mean, I think so. So the traffic isn't the best, but it's still manageable, of course. There are still enough tables. There are still enough bad players that you can play profitably. So yeah, it's fine. But of course, it's the whole poker is a bit drying up. I mean, there's less traffic year by year, so it's the same with fixed limit hold'em. So yeah, traffic is I mean, action is a bit worse, I think. I mean not think, I'm pretty sure it's a bit worse, but games are actually awesome. So yeah. I am playing way more 10, 20 and 15, 30 tables this year than I was playing last year, just because, yeah, like I said, there's enough action there, so it's pretty good. I actually have like a spreadsheet with my sessions that I play every day, and I'm also tracking my VPP points per day, per hour, and per hands and stuff like that. And my VPP per hand increased by like 25% since last year, so that's pretty crazy. Maybe even more than 20. Yeah, let's say 25%. So yeah, that means that I'm playing way higher. I mean, I'm playing way more higher limits than last year. What was the name of the it's table? I'm just going to write it: Table Scan Turbo. It's not a free software. I think it's like $70 or something like that. But if you're playing a bit higher stakes, I mean, if you're not playing micro stakes, it's a pretty good investment. So I would pay way more for software like that. Way more than 75. I think it's $75. Yeah, I would pay way more than $75. What's your opinion about Rush Poker? Rush Poker is on Full Tilt, right? PokerStars has Zoom Poker. PokerStars has Zoom Poker. I think it's great. I don't know. I think all the games might be Zoom in some point in the future. I don't know. People, some players are. I mean, it's good because you can just sit down, start the Zoom pool, and you can stand up whenever you want. You can come back like in 5 minutes or 1 hour or 2 hours. It doesn't matter. So I think that's pretty great. It's unfortunately it doesn't run for a fixed limit hold'em. The community and the traffic is just a bit too small. But yeah, I think it's pretty nice. Especially if someone is trying to get the highest status, VIP status here on PokerStars as possible. You can get so many hands in. You can be supernova like nothing really. Even supernova elite if you're playing a bit higher. So yeah, I think Zoom Poker is pretty good. Tables can work for Bovada Bodog. I have no idea. I am PokerStars playing. I'm playing only on PokerStars, so no idea. I'm pretty sure it says on the site, so just look it up and you'll see. If it's listed there, it's available. If not, it's not. Volleyballs here bluffed me. Not sure why. I'm pretty sure I wouldn't do that with a worse hand than ace high, and I definitely didn't believe him having a 3 there because he's a bit tighter, so I don't believe he could have an ace 3 there, but that's probably the only hand that I would believe him. I wouldn't, let's see, like, yeah, like that. I mean, he could slow play like an ace 5. I don't believe he has a king, a better king than mine, because I mean, it's a less of an option because I have a king already, so that wasn't the best race against me, I think. Against some other players, maybe, I don't know, but no one is folding. I mean, we could be real here, no one is folding a pair of king here, so yeah. You are $6 profit so far today. Yes, that is correct, sir. We started with 20 bucks. And we are almost $7 in profit, so we raised our bankroll by more than one third, so that's pretty awesome. Got check raised here, and now I have the call. Okay, he checks. I was saying, I mean, I'm scared of Jack 10, of course, but now that he checks on the river, I'm pretty sure he doesn't have a Jack 10. Okay, here Queen 10. It was fine hand to play like that. I think it would be better for him to check raise the flop already. Not sure he waited for the turn, but yeah, it's fine. Was it easier to make profit where there were more bad players? Yeah, of course it was easier. It was way easier. But it's still you are good. If it was easier, yeah, it was much easier, of course, but it's still fixed limit still good enough to make profit even in today's game. So obviously they are tougher than they were 6 years ago, but still I'm still progressing. I'm still progressing through limits. It's not like that I'm going downwards, I'm actually going up. So yeah, this is like a pretty bad call. I think I have enough outs for either a deuce or an ace. Now I have to, of course, raise my straight here. If I get three bet, I'm hurting right now. Oh, I'm in pain. I guess I have to call. Or not. I can fold. I think I can fold. I folded a straight in 5 10 cents table. Volleyballs. Volley boys is asking me something. Not sure why. If you guys have any question, don't do it like Luca and then wait that I respond. Just ask me a question. I'm going to respond. It's no problem, really. Thank you. Wish PokerStars would work. Come back to the US. I miss it. Yeah, I know. Oh, that's why he was asking me. Can you please send me $1 or $2? Can't really do that. Sorry. If I would do that all the time, I mean, I have to say no to everyone. I mean, if I start giving out money like that for free, that would just be that's just not a good practice, really. People would start asking me all the time. I mean, they are already asking me all the time anyway, so it would even be worse if I start actually giving out. So I just have to say no to basically everyone. So I mean, I do some giveaway. I'll make some giveaways maybe later in my later streams. But for now, I'm sorry, I just have to say no. Did you guys see Phil Ivey won another tournament in Australia? That one, that 250k challenge in Aussie Millions. He won it for the third time in the last 4 years. That's so sick. That's unbelievable, really. I think Mickey Peterson said the Phil Ivey is the Phil Ivey of poker, something like that. Let me just Google real quick what he said. It was really funny. He said that on Twitch. Phil Ivey is the Phil Ivey of poker. Yeah, that's so true. He won it a third time. Where's the kitty cat? Well, the kitty cat was naughty, so he's not in my room today. I was playing my my regular play yesterday. Oh, Boronik is here on the table. He's from Slovenia. Let's just a second. I was playing like my regular limits yesterday. I was like in a really big pot. I flopped the nut flush draw. I flopped the nut flush, not nut flush draw. And he jumped on my computer, on my case, and he pressed on reset button. So I was really pissed at that point. So I don't want him near the computer anymore. At least not for the time being, or definitely not while I stream. Don't want him pressing buttons on my case, really. So he's in the other room, waiting for me to finish, really. So yeah, he was a naughty boy. I was calling here for my backdoor flush draw, my backdoor straight draw, and maybe my pair are good sometimes, so probably not against four players, but the pot is so big that I just can't fold. But now I hit that's like the perfect, really the perfect turn here. So I have a open-ended now, I have a second nut flush draw, so I am not going to raise. That would be a bit too much, I think. I mean, I could raise, but I could raise here, actually. I'm going to raise here. I'm raising here for value. I mean, it's a bit weird that I'm raising this hand, right? And I'm just calling. I'm just check folding the river. Yeah, now check folding the river. That's a bit silly, but I guess I have to do that against three other players. Pot was so big. Maximux. Okay, Maxi. Oh, he actually had Cannibal here, had a flush or two and a two pair. So there some outs went to him, but that was expected. Of course, I was expecting someone to have a jack. I was expecting someone even to have a six there or something like that. So, but yeah. Let's see. You think fixed limit hold'em requires more skill than no limit hold'em? I mean, it's really hard to compare these two games, really. People think it's pretty much the same, just that fixed limit doesn't have a all-in button, but it's really not true. I mean, it's really, really different game. Opening ranges are different. You play way more hands here in fixed limit than in no limit. I'm playing more than one third of my hands. You see so many more streets in fixed limit hold'em. You see way more flops, way more turns, way more rivers. You go like 40% of the time you go to the showdown, so you have to make so many more decisions. But those decisions, even if you make a bad decision, is such a small mistake, really. I mean, if you make, I mean, you have to call like one. For example, I have to call one big bet here on the turn. Even if it's a mistake, it's not a one big bet mistake. It's like maybe 1.5 or my 5.7, I mean 0.7 or 0.6 of a mistake, or a big blind mistake. So yeah. So saying all that, I don't think it requires more skill. I think these are just two different games. It requires different skill. I mean, if a best fixed limit player would go to the no limit he wouldn't do good, right? And if no limit, good no limit player would went to the fixed limit, he wouldn't do good either. So it's just different skill, really. Yeah, that fault, yeah, I agree. How many tables do you do?